Coach LaHoy, I'd like to start with you. As far as that overtime goal goes, not the way that you coaches drew it up, can you talk about what the play that you guys had in set was?
The play was just flat out get to the hoop and shoot it as hard as you can. King stood in his head every one of those overtimes in the entire second half. We just said keep on shooting and scrap for every ground ball. This offense doesn't give up. We'll take it any way we can get it. These guys are blue-collar kids. It's not about the show. We're happy to have the win.
What was the mindset that you coaches had that tried to instill on your players when you guys went down one goal in the third quarter?
We talked about it actually on the bus. We've been talking about it for the last 3 weeks. These guys hear it every single day. We need to be steady Eddie. No matter what the situation is, do your very best to take the emotion out of the game and focus on what you can control. And that's executing and never giving up, never taking no for an answer.
All right, Matt, on the defensive side of things, talk about how you guys were able to adjust from giving up those goals in the third quarter into overtime where you didn't allow any.
Well, lacrosse is a game of momentum and game of swings, and we had to make a stop. So we had to get behind our goalie. He's one hell of a keeper. Kid stands in and he makes a lot of saves. So we just had to be able to rally together. And you'll hear us on the field when we say our cheers. We do it together. We do it as family. And we had to be a family out there and be able to pull together to make a big stop. So.
As your coach said, this isn't the finish line. What kind of preparations do you guys have to prepare for Saturday's game in the championship?
Flush this. It's over. It's done. It's like we need to move on to the next one. It's like get this out of our minds because, like you said, you know, another race coming. So we got to play our game.
All right. Thank you, Matt. Brian, can you talk about that overtime goal, kind of being in the right place at the right time?
I mean, that's really what it was, just being in the right place at the right time. Any one of us on that field could have been there and could have done the same thing I did. I just happened to be there, and we finished strong. I mean, we've done plenty of situations and all of our practices to prepare us for this. And when it came, I mean, we pulled through, and it happened. And so we're looking forward to the next round.
Offensively, you guys were able to stay very patient despite the run made by the Johnnies. How were you able to do that?
Just through composure. I mean, like Brad said, we've been talking about this past 3 weeks. We knew that teams were going to make their runs, and it was up to us to keep our composure so when that time came, we could have our comeback and finish strong at the end of the game.
All right. Certainly rode the backs of that defense. This was not an offensive game by any means.
Yes.
This was not an offensive game by any means. This was a defensive game, and the defense saved our butts. The offense has the easiest job in the world, and they know that. And once again, the team picks itself up, but boy, our goalie and those close defensemen and our short, sick D midfielders were getting picked on all day, and they rose to the challenge. Very proud. Very proud.
Well, thank you guys for taking the time to do this interview, and congratulations on your win once again, and good luck in the championship.